An abstract data type, or ADT in short, is a mathematical model for data types. Where you have the data type defined by its semantics, which means its behavior, from a point of view of a user, which in this case is a programmer. And in what parts are we looking at the semantics? We are looking in possible values that data could have that you store in those data types, the possible operations you want to do on this data of this particular type, and the specific behavior of the individual operations. As far as it concerns this lecture, we will use a very simplified imperative representation and not a mathematical model. In an ADT, you can generally support various types of data, or it can be generic, such that it deals with any types of numerical data, for instance, like integers, float, and long data. In C, if you want to represent generic types, we use typically a void star, so a pointer to some undefined data structure, which allows us to store any type of information. The implementation of such an ADT can be done using one or many different data structures, each having positive or negative aspects in terms of their performance characteristics. So we may treat the time and space complexity against each other, and so on. So let's get started with a basic abstract data type, which is a container. So a container is used in many ADTs, and sometimes it's also called a collection. What does it do? Well, it manages instances of objects. And these objects, instances, are typically called elements. A collection or a container can support a specific type, like an integer, or it can be support in any arbitrary type or multiple types that have special properties. Like I said, could be numerical data. A container has three basic properties: access, which is the way of how you access the individual elements of the container; storage, the way you store the objects in the container; and the way, lastly, the way how you iterate over the objects in a container. Typical operations that we encounter is to insert a specific element, which means to add the element into the container somewhere, to delete a specific element from a container, to delete all the elements in a container, to somehow retrieve an element in a container, or to count the number of elements in a container. So a queue is an exemplary ADT. It is a collection supporting NQ and DQing of items following a first in, first out principle. So it means the first element that you add is retrieved first. Here's a visualization. So we can enqueue an element, and we enqueue another element, and enqueue another element, and so on. And finally, when you dequeue from such a queue an element, well, you get always the first enqueued element. So it's really like a waiting queue in real life into the supermarket, and so on. So two operations that you support is enqueue an element, which means to put it at the back to the queue. Sometimes this operation is called push or push back. Then we have dequeue, which removes our front element of the queue. Sometimes this operation is called pop or pop front. Optional operations that are sometimes supported by such an ADT are peak. That means you can look at this element up front, but you don't remove it, or size, well, you to get the number of elements in such a queue. Our next abstract data type is a stack. Well, and we know the stack already from the, because that's the way how our memory is organized, how our stack frames are managed. And here it's we are talking about the abstract data type, where you have a collection of elements of any type, and it uses the last in, first out, or LIFO principle. So you have here two operations: push, to means to add the element to the collection, and to pop, to remove the most recently added element from the collection. You can think of the stack like a stack of papers. When you put on top another sheet of paper, well, you cannot pull down the piece of paper that is on the bottom onto the table. You would always remove the paper basically on top. So that's what a stack does. You put everything on top, and then you remove the newest element again. And again, we can do peak and size operations, for example. A stack can be implemented as an array or list. And how this works We will discuss in the following. We will have basically a look at both implementations.